I'm standing in the middle of College Avenue, just in front of Pearson Hall. On this spot stood a minor character in Pomona College's history.
It was a tree, specifically an oak tree, and according to the Claremont Heritage Society, it was probably planted by Frank P. Brackett, who also planted the eucalyptus trees along College Avenue, and for whom the Pomona College Observatory was named. The tree was featured on postcards, and in the late 1920s, the trunk was painted white for safety.
But by 1938, it was gone. Go Kansas City!
It was March 3rd, 1938, the day after the flood. The newspaper headlines bristled with news about damage and destruction. But after a few days, the novelty wore off and the headlines went back to the more mundane. The huge job of cleaning up began. Sadly, Tiny Thompson Creek Dam isn't much help against the floodwaters. Soon after, a 9-foot-high flood wall is built along 9th Street to replace the one which collapsed during a previous flood in 1916. These floods would continue until the San Antonio Dam was finally constructed in 1956. It was 1939, and Glenn Miller's Moonlight Serenade was topping the charts. The president's residence, the Revell House, is built on the Scripps campus, and 16 American elms are planted, which became the beautiful Elm Tree Lawn. On the Pomona campus, the original pipe organ in the Bridges Hall of Music is replaced with a molar. Then in 2002, it is replaced with a Fisk organ, which is still in use today. In 1940, the clouds of war in Europe gathered, and all men in Claremont between the ages of 21 and 35 must register for selective service. Also, a terrible flu epidemic swept through the campuses, and 50 students a week were infected. For the first time since its inception, Pomona College closed its doors and told its students to go home for the balance of the year. It was 1941 and Glenn Miller was topping the charts again with In the Mood. The colleges again find themselves in debt, and President Edmonds retires, and Elijah Wilson Lyons becomes the college's 6th president, also the longest serving, holding the office for 28 years. It's 1942 now, and all Japanese Americans in Claremont are due to be sent to internment camp. President Lyons secretly arranges for one of his Japanese junior students, Sue Hisanjay, to be transferred to Oberlin College in Ohio, and he allows her brother Kizo to graduate early to avoid internment. Lyon also devised an accelerated program, keeping the college open all year so that male students could complete their degree before military service. A class of 1943 alumni, Art Clokey, later created a little film in a film class he took at USC. The 3-minute experimental film was called Gumbasia, and just happened to capture the attention of 20th Century Fox. His characters Gumby and Pokey debuted on the Howdy Doody Show, landing their own TV series in 1957.
The job of swelling the United States Army goes full speed ahead.
In 1944, enrollment drops from 818 to 515 as men are called away to war. Each student had to give 2 to 4 hours a week for war work, or campus service. This work consisted of buying war bonds and stamps, donating blood, rolling bandages, and knitting blankets for wounded soldiers. That year, of the 97 students graduating, only 5 were men. In August, the first atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima, then Nagasaki. The war was over by the end of that month, and the boys came home soon after. In fact, the return of veterans to campus exacerbated an ongoing campus housing crisis. The number of women students increased as well. In 2 years, enrollment would swell from 659 to 1,110, and student housing was desperately needed. In 1946, tuition was increased to $400, an extension to Blaisdell Hall was completed by Thanksgiving, and work began on the adjoining Mud Hall as well. But that would not be enough. The consortium convened and decided another entire college would be needed. In September 1946, 86 students and 7 faculty members opened a new undergraduate school for men to be named Claremont Men's College, or CMC, and it would be the 4th of the Claremont Colleges. It would be renamed Claremont McKenna College in 1981 after Donald McKenna, its founding benefactor, and it would occupy 69 acres of the Scripps undeveloped land. Many of the first students lived temporarily in the basement of Bridges Auditorium. Potted palms were placed in the quarters to liven the atmosphere, prompting students to call their new home the Coconut Grove. CMC's Bower Hall broke ground in September, then the North Mall, followed with a dining hall. Over on the Scripps campus, Alfredo Ramos Martinez, the father of Mexican mural movement of the 20th century, is commissioned to create the flower vendors in the Margaret Fowler Garden. He falls ill, and on November 8, 1946, he dies, leaving the mural unfinished. In 1947, Mud Hall opens on Pomona's campus. Commencement ceremonies are held for the first time on the Elm Tree Lawn at Scripps, and that tradition continues today. In 1949, Gibson Dining Hall opens on the Pomona campus, and it's decorated with original watercolors by Milford Zorns, class of 1934. The same artist commissioned to paint the mural in the Claremont Post Office soon after graduation. Frank Dining Hall, to serve the Harwood Hall residents, also opened that year. Just in time for the holidays, a rare snow fell that year to the delight of the students. 1950 saw Pomona College break ground on the Memorial Gymnasium with an entrance on 6th Street near Alumni Field. A fire at the outdoor Greek Theater completely burned the wooden bleachers down, which were never reconstructed. Also that year, construction begins on Honold Library. In 1951, KPCR, Pomona's first student-operated radio station, began broadcasting as a tiny AM station housed in a closet in Edmonds Union. 5 years later, it became KSPC, an FM station that broadcast from studios in the basement of the Thatcher Music Building. Clever President Lyons convinced some high-profile clients to lease college properties as a way to create ongoing income. Rancho Santa Ana Botanic Gardens moved from its original location in Orange County to Claremont, onto the Piedmont Mesa, not far from where the original college cornerstone was laid back in 1887.
One, two, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. Put your glad rags on.
There were two Renwick gymnasiums on Pomona's campus. The original was built in 1899 and the second in 1918. In 1952, the original Renwick gymnasium burned to the ground. The second remained until demolition in 1982. Work begins on Walker Hall, and the Honold Library was completing, serving all of the colleges, meaning that the smaller individual libraries, like Pomona's Carnegie and Scripps Denison, could be used for other purposes. The movie Trouble Along the Way was filmed behind little bridges in Liebes Court, but since it was supposed to be a convent, Pan, the flute player, was replaced with Madonna. In that film, there was an extra making his debut in movies. His name was James Dean.
Well, since my baby left me, well, I found a new place to dwell. Well, it's down at the end of Lonely Street, that heartbreak hotel where I'll be.
The year was 1954, and Walker Hall had just been dedicated on the Pomona campus after it received a gift from Helen Walker of Glendale, who left her estate to Pomona College valued at over $700,000. It was the largest single gift ever made to the college. The Sage Hen football team went undefeated that year, a feat it's never been able to repeat. It's now 1955, with computing and technology developing and flush with newly acquired funds, the consortium charters another college with an emphasis upon science and engineering to be named after Harvey Seeley Mudd, who was the director of Claremont Graduate University for 25 years and who had just died. HMC would be the fourth undergraduate college, but the fifth entity of the seven colleges we know today. Still needing student residences in 1956, an extension was added to Clark Hall along 6th Street, and a curving 5-foot wall was built as a flood break along the northern edge of the grassy area known as Walker Beach. In later years, this wall would become known as Pomona College's Free Speech Wall. In that same year, when Walker Wall was built on campus to divert floodwaters, a far more effective protection took place with the completion of San Antonio Canyon Dam to the north, which ended Claremont's history of periodic flooding.
Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching it as much as I enjoyed making it. And if you stuck it out this long, please consider subscribing to my channel. And there's a little bell there. If you ring the bell, you'll be notified every time I make a new video. See you later. Thanks again for watching.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
I'm standing right in the middle of College Avenue in front of Pearson Hall, and on the